Now, we find here in verse 20, but the chief priests and elders persuaded the multitude that they should ask Barabbas and destroy Jesus. You see, the religious rulers circulated among the crowd. They're clever politicians themselves. And they said, now the thing to do is to ask that Barabbas be delivered and to destroy Jesus. And the governor answered and said unto them, whether of the twain will ye that I release unto you? They said, Barabbas. And this man Pilate, here he's taken aback for a moment. He never dreamed they would stoop to do a thing like this. But he didn't know how low religion could stoop. Verse 22, Pilate saith unto them, what shall I do then with Jesus, which is called Christ? And friends, why should he ask the crowd for the decision? He's the judge. He should have made the decision. Now, we'll find out in the other Gospels, especially John. John tells us how many times that Pilate called him back on the inside. And what he's really saying to the Lord Jesus, if you'll cooperate with me, I can get you out of this, and he'll get me off of a hot seat that I'd like to be off of. Actually, when you read this in all the four Gospels, you find out that Jesus is really not on trial, but Pilate is. He had to make a decision relative to Jesus Christ. Our Lord's not trying to escape at all. And so he asks the crowd, imagine a Roman judge asking a crowd, what'll I do then with Jesus? And I tell you, it came back to him, it was flung in his face. They all say unto him, let him be crucified. And the governor said, why? What evil hath he done? But a mob never has a reason, but they cried out the more, saying, let him be crucified. When Pilate saw that he could prevail nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, he took water, washed his hands before the multitude, saying, I'm innocent of the blood of this just person. See ye to it. Now, he called for a basin, washed his hands, said he'd have nothing to do with it. But it's not that easy, you see. He had to make a decision. Every man does. What think ye of Christ is the test, to try both your state and your station. You can't be right in the rest until you think rightly of him. What do you think of Christ? That's the important one. And he tried to wash his hands. But the bitter irony is that the oldest creed that the church has this statement, crucified under Pontius Pilate. He didn't really wash his hands of this deed. The blood of Jesus was on his hands. Verse 25, then answered all the people and said, his blood be on us and on our children. And unfortunately, that has been true and can be demonstrated. Verse 26, then released he Barabbas unto them, and when he had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. Now, Pilate's willing to stoop this low himself. He had to make a decision, and his decision, of course, is one of rejection. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the common hall, gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers, and they stripped him and put on him a scarlet robe. And now they'll do with him as they please. They'll ridicule him. He becomes a plaything for this brutal, cruel crowd. And when they had platted a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand, and they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, hail, King of the Jews. May I say to you, this is frightful that they did. They spit upon him. This had happened before. They took the reed and smote him on the head. I believe that he was beaten into a pulp. Friends, he was marred more than any man, is the way Isaiah describes it in the 53rd chapter. Now, verse 31 here, and after that, they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him, and put his own raiment on him, and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name, him they compelled to bear his cross.